Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. Today in this video, we will see how to establish the communication between the Bluetooth modules. I am going to use two HC-05 modules, one as the master, and another as the slave. We will first see how to set these modules in their respective modes, and how to establish the connection between them. Then we will communicate between two STM32 devices using Bluetooth. So let's start with the HC-05 datasheet first. The HC-05 can be used in both the master and the slave mode. It supports all kinds of baud rates used in UART communication. In default configuration, it has the baud rate of 38,400, with one stop bit and no parity. The default pairing pin is 0000. Actually, this information can change with firmware, so we will see it ourselves. We can configure the different settings for the module in the AT command mode. So let's put the device in the AT command mode first. So here I have both the modules on the same breadboard. Let's see the pins available on this module. We have the enable pin, which is used to put the module in the AT mode. Then there is VCC, ground, TX, RX, and the state pin. The VCC needs to be between 3.6 to 6 volts, so I will provide 5 volts to the module. First, I am going to use the AT commands, so I am connecting the module directly to the FT232 USB to TTL converter. The connection is going to be a cross connection. The blue wire is connected to the RX of the TTL converter, so it connects with the TX of the Bluetooth module. Similarly, the yellow wire connects between the TX of the converter and the RX of the Bluetooth. Now connect the enable pin to the 5 volts, so the module can go in the AT mode. Now power the board, and notice the LED blinking pattern. Initially, both the red and the blue LEDs blinks very fast, but once the module goes into the AT mode, the red LED blinks every 2 seconds. This is the confirmation that the module has entered the AT command mode. Now let's open a serial terminal to send the commands to the module. This is the port where the USB to TTL converter is connected. We will use the baud rate of 38,400, with 8 data bits, 1 stop bit, and no parity. Let's connect to the device. Make sure to use the carriage return and line feed to the end of the command. Alright, let's send the AT command. The module returned OK, so it is ready for communication. This is the command we sent just now. I am only going to cover the important commands needed for this tutorial, you can see the rest yourself. AT plus ORGL can be used to reset the module back to its original configuration. After issuing this command, the module goes back into its default configuration, where it is in slave mode with the pairing pin as 1234. I am going to leave this module in the slave mode and set another module in the master mode. So we would need the address of this module. Let's copy this address command, and we will send it to the module. The module has returned its address. We will need this address so the master can pair with this module. We can check the name of the module with this command. Here the module has returned its name, HC-05. We can also rename the module to something else. Make sure there is no space when you are typing a command. Once the module accepts the command, it returns OK. The roll command can be used to set the module in the master or slave mode. Let's check the current roll of the module. It is returning an error. Let me type the command myself. Alright, the roll is set to 0, which is the slave mode. We want this module in the slave mode, so let's leave it to this. The password command can be used to check the pairing pin. It is set to 1234, we can change it to something else, but I am leaving it as default. The UART command is used to configure the module's UART settings. The first parameter is the baud rate, then the stop bit, and at last the parity. Currently the module is configured to use the baud rate of 9600, with no stop bit and no parity. I have no idea how it goes with zero stop bits, but anyway we will configure it ourselves. We will set it to use the baud rate of 11500, with one stop bit, and no parity. Alright, the module confirmed the settings we used. We will also configure the STM32 in a similar way. We don't need to worry about other commands, this is enough to set the module in the slave mode. Make sure to keep the address, as we are going to need it for the master. Alright, let's connect another module now. I am connecting the second module in a similar way. Now disconnect the power, and connect it back. You can see the second module has gone into the AT mode. Let's continue with the serial terminal. Let's confirm the AT command. Alright, the module is responding fine. Let's change its name to HC-05 Master. We will set this module in the master mode, so the role needs to be set to 1. Right now, in the default configuration, the role is set to 0. So change it to 1. Alright, the role has been changed. Now we need to connect to the slave module. First we will set the connect mode to 0, so that this module can only connect to the fixed address. And now we will bind the module to the slave address. We already have the slave address, so copy it. Now replace the colons with a comma. The module responded okay, so it will connect to the slave when we power it the next time. That is all the configuration we need. Let's remove the wire, and power both the modules. The LED blinks fast when the module is not connected to anything. Once the connection is established, the LEDs blinks twice in every 2 seconds. To make sure that the connection is established, I am going to send the test data to one module, and receive it from another module. The blue wire is connected between the TX of the slave mode and the RX of the converter. And the yellow wire is connected between the RX of the master and the TX of the converter. Basically, the data is going to be transmitted from the converter to the master. The master will send the data to the slave. The slave will then send this data back to the converter, and we should see it on the terminal. Make sure to change the baud rate, the communication baud rate is set to 11500. Let's and hello. Here we have received the same data back to the terminal. So the connection is established successfully, and the modules are able to communicate with each other. Now let's start the cube ID, so to set up the things on STM32 controllers. I am using F103C8, and the F446RE controllers. We will start with the F103C8 setup first. Give some name to the project and click Finish. We will start with the clock setup. The board has 8 MHz crystal on it, and I am running the system at maximum 72 MHz. Now go to UART1, and enable the asynchronous mode. Make sure the configuration here is the same as what we did for the modules. The baud rate is 115200, with one stop bit and no parity. Now go to the NVIC tab, and enable the interrupt. The pins PA9 and PA10 got selected as the UART TX and RX pins. We will connect these pins with the Bluetooth module. Use the cross connection again, with TX of the module connected to the RX of the STM32, and vice versa. Let's enable the UART2, so that we can communicate with the computer also. Enable the interrupt again. The configuration should be the same as the UART1. The pins PA2 and PA3 got selected for the UART, so connect them to the USB to TTL converter. Use the cross connection again, with TX of the module connected to the RX of the STM32, and vice versa. We always use the cross connection as UART, so there should be no second thoughts here. That is all the setup we need, so click Save to generate the project. Let's write the code now. Define an array to store the data. Now in the main function, we will receive the data in the idle line interrupt mode. The data will be stored in the data array, and we will receive a maximum of 64 bytes at once. I hope you are familiar with the idle line mode. If not, then check out the video on the top right corner. We will do the same for the UART2 also. Now if all the 64 bytes have been received, or if the UART detects an idle line before that, an interrupt will trigger, and the RX event callback will be called. Inside the callback we will check if the interrupt is triggered by the USART1. If it is, then we will send the received data to the UART2. The size parameter holds the actual number of bytes received by the UART. And if it is triggered by the USART2, then we will send the data to the UART1. The HOL disables the interrupt after each call, so in the end we will call the receiveToIdleInterrupt function again. I am passing the parameter HUART, so to make sure the same instance is being passed as whichever called this interrupt. Alright, we are ready with our F103 code, so let's flash it to the board. Now let's create a new project, and do the same for the F446RE. Here I am using the UART4 to connect to the module. This is because the pins are easily available for UART4. We will connect another Bluetooth module to these pins. Again use the cross connection to connect the TX and RX pins. The configuration should be the same as the others. Enable the interrupt for the UART4. I am going to use the UART2 to connect the F446 to the computer. The UART2 routes the data through the SD link, so it doesn't need any additional hardware. That is it for the F446, let's generate the project now. We will use the same that we wrote for the F103. Let's copy it. Here instead of USART1, we are using UART4. Note the names here, UART4 is not USART4. The rest of the code will remain the same as the F103. Alright, let's build and flash this to the F446. Let me remove the F103 from this computer. I am going to connect one of the controllers to this computer, and another controller to another computer. Both the serial softwares are configured with the same settings that we used for the controllers and the modules. You can now see how we will send the data from one computer to another computer, using STM32 and the Bluetooth. so the data transmission is working fine. I hope you understood how to communicate using the Bluetooth modules. You can directly connect your phone or computer to the slave module, and use some Bluetooth serial software to send and receive data. This is it for this video. The link to download the code and the schematics is in the description below. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.